Welcome in the world of artificial intelligence under artificial intelligence using Python series of lectures. This is lecture on heuristic search methods part 6. Hi, I am Dr. Sunil from GCS Solutions. The contents of this lecture are search algorithms. So we'll see best first search and the analysis of best first search. The best first search is the modified version of DFS wherein the open list in the DFS is sorted based on some heuristic value of the nodes in the search space. So in case of DFS, the MoveGen function will generate the child node of n. Now these child nodes or children are added to the existing open and this open is directly used. But in case of best first search, the open is sorted and then that sorted open list is used for further processing. Now let us try to understand first the graph on which we want to apply the best first search algorithm. So graph has some nodes like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K and L. Now here A is connected to B, B is connected to C and C is connected to A. Now here H, B, AB, BC and CA, these are undirected and there is also H from B to D and B to E. That means B is connected to D, B is connected to E as well, but these are directed edges. So this whole graph is basically converted into the representation called state space representation, which is nothing but the list of successors. So for a node A, so focus here where I'm pointing. A has successor B and C, so it is specified here B and C. Now B has successors A, C, D and E, so B has successor A, C, D and E, which is represented here in the list. So this list is basically a dictionary having key value pair. So key is any node, given node, for example A, B, C, D, F and G, and here the values are the successor of the given node. For example, C has successor A, B, F and G. So here C has successor A, B, F and G. Also D has successor H and I. That means D is connected to H and I. F is connected to J and G is connected to K and A, L, that is represented over here. Now here all the leaf nodes are the nodes having no successor. That's why these are leaf nodes. So these are not specified in this successor list. So apart from this, the given condition is that start node is A and the goal node which is to be found is H. Now here if you see carefully, each of the node has a pair, that is node name and heuristic value. For example, 5 is heuristic value of A, 3 is heuristic value of B and C is heuristic value of, 2 is heuristic value of C. So this way all these nodes are having their respective heuristic values. Now let us try to understand the actual algorithm. So best first search algorithm will take a start node. So initially the open will be assigned a start. So that means we'll start with the given start node. Close is empty and state is failure because the state variable represents the state whether the goal node is found or not. If goal node is found, then state will be success. So here initially, as there is at least one node in the open, so it starts with the algorithm. So open is not empty and state is also not success. Then it will execute this whole while loop. So it picks the front node from the open and it removes that node from the open. Now it checks whether the given node n is goal or not. It now calls the goal test function. Goal test function checks whether the given node is goal or not. If it is goal, it returns true, otherwise it returns false. Now if goal node returns the true, then state will be success and this node is added to the closed. What if goal node returns false, then it will get into else part and it will add the node n, current node, to the closed. It will call movegen. Now what movegen does, it takes the current node n. As it is not goal node, so it will generate the child node. So it will create a temporary list, success list, and then it will first search that given node is appearing in the list of successor S or not. If it is, then it fetches the child node of the n and will store in success and will return here. So this movegen nodes will be stored in child list, and from the child list whatever is there in the open and as well as whatever there is in the close, that is removed. Why these steps are required? Because there should not be getting into infinite loop, that is visiting the nodes again and again, same nodes again and again. So that problem is addressed over here. Now once the child node is created by removing whatever is there in the open and close, that child is added at different of the open. Now this open, which is the combination of the existing open and the newly generated child nodes or children nodes, this open is sorted. So what this append does, it takes two lists and it adds the two contents of the two lists and makes a combined list and returns to the algorithm best first search. Now after this, the sort algorithm is called. So what this sort does, it takes the list L and it sorts the nodes of the list L based on their heuristic value. So this way the sort algorithm will be called here, and the open will be having all the nodes which are sorted, and this open will be used for the further iteration. Now let us apply this algorithm on the given graph which is discussed earlier. Now here this is the graph and these are the list of successors. So here in this case, the start node is A, initially closed is empty, state is failure because goal is not yet found. So open is having A, at least one node, so it is not empty, and state is failure, which is not success. So both the conditions are true, so it will get into the while loop. Now it will pick the front node from the open, which is A. It will remove it from the open. Open is empty at this point of time. It will check whether A is goal. So as A is not goal, it returns false. So goal test will return false and it will get into the else part. So it appends the given node A to the close, and close is basically the list which maintains the nodes visited so far. So now here it will call the movegen function for the A, and movegen will return the child node of A. So here in the successor list, first A search, A is there in the list. So the child node of A are B and C, those are returned by the movegen and will be stored in the child. Now from the child, whatever there is in the open, that is removed. So there is nothing in the open, so nothing is to be removed from the child. And also from this child, whatever is there in the close, now in close there is only one node A, that is that node if appears in the child is to be removed. So that node is not appearing, so there is nothing to be removed, so child will remain same. Now here the child is added at the front of the existing open, so existing open is empty, and to that B and C is added, so open will be B and C, but this open will not be kept as it is. So rather sort algorithm will be called, then sort will sort the nodes in the open. Now open will be C and B. Now with this new open, next iteration will be executed. Now in this iteration, open is having two nodes C and B, which is not empty, and state is also failure, which is not success. So it picks the front node from the open, which is C. It will remove it from the open. Now open will be having B. It will check with the goal test whether C is goal or not. As C is not goal, so it will be false, then it will get into else part, then it will add the C to the closed. So closed is having all the nodes visited so far. Now here for this node C, movegen will be called. Now for node C, the movegen will see the child nodes, which are nothing but A, B, F and G, which is mentioned in the successors list. So for C, the nodes are A, B, F and G. So movegen will return this children list of C and will be stored in the child of the best first search. Now from this child, whatever is there in the open, that is removed. So in open there is B, so B is removed from this child, so child will be having A, F and G. Also from this child, whatever is there in the closed, that is removed. So in closed there is A and C, so it will be checked that whether A and C are appearing in the child. Now in child A is appearing, so that is removed. So at the end child will be having F and G, and this child F and G will be added at the front of the existing open. Existing open has B, and now F and G are added, so open will be F, G and B. But open is sorted using the sort function, which will sort the open based on the heuristic value. So lower heuristic value will be appearing at the front, so it will be F, B and G. Now with this new open, next iteration will be executed. Now here we have F, B and G in the open. Now open is not empty and state is failure, which is not success, so conditions are true. So it will now pick the front node from the open, which is F. F is removed from the open, so open will be having B and G. Now it will check whether F is goal. As F is not goal, so goal test function returns false, so it will get into else part. Now this current node F is appended to the open. Open will be having A, C and F. Now here the movegen function is called for F. Now for F, if you see the successor list, there is only one child, that is called J. So that is return, and from this child whatever is there in the open and as well as in the close, that is removed. So if you see carefully, there is nothing to be removed from the child, so child will remain safe. Now this child is added at the front of the open, so open has B and G, so at the front J is added, so open will be J, B and G. Now it is sorted after this, so it will be B, G and J. Now with this new open, next iteration will be executed. Now here open is having B, G and J, so open is not empty, state is also failure, which is not success, so conditions are true, so it will execute the while loop. It picks the front node from the open, which is B. Now B is removed from the open, so open is having G and J, so it checks whether B is now the goal or not. B is not goal, so it returns the goal test return false, so it will get into else part. Now here that B is added to the closed. Now closed is having A, C, F and B. Now if you see carefully, that closed maintains all the nodes visited so far. So here if you see very carefully, then our execution was from A to C, C to F and from F to B. Now here abruptly it has changed the path. Why? Because if we go to J, J is not going to give solution, because J is the node having higher heuristic value. So here the lower heuristic value B will be appearing at the front, and that's why this will be picked, and our path of the search now has got changed from A to B, and it will be leading to goal now. So here the movegen function for B is called. So B has children A, C, D and E, that will be written by movegen, will be stored in child, and from this child whatever is there in the open, that is removed, so there is nothing to be removed, and also whatever there is in the closed, that is removed. So here A, C are appearing in the child, so that will be removed. So at the end child will be having D and E, and this child is added at the front of the open. Now at this point of time open is G and J, so that G and J, at the front of G and J, D and E is D and E are added, and your new open will be D, E, G and J. But this open is sorted, and that will be D, E, G and J, and that sorted open will be used for the next. Now here open is having D, E, G and J. It is not empty, state is failure, which is not success, and it will pick now the open front node, that is D, because these conditions are true, so it will execute the while loop. So it picks the D. Now D is the frontier, and as it is frontier it will be picked, and now it is removed from the open, so open will be having E, G and J. It checks whether D is goal or not. D is not goal node, so it will get into else part, as goal test returns false. Now here that current node D is added to the closed, so closed will be having A, C, F, B and D. Now here for D, movegen will be called, so D is checked in the successor list, it is present, so the successor of D are H and I, that is written by the movegen and stored here in the child, And from this child, whatever is there in the open and in and there is in the close, that is removed. So there is nothing to be removed, so child will remain same. So this child is added at the front of the open. Now open has G and J, and that is basically, that is E, G and J, and to this E, G and J, H and I are added. So your open is H, I, E, G and J, but it is sorted first. So it will be H, E, G, I and J. Now here, this new open will be used for the next iteration. Now in this iteration, your new open is H, E, G, I and J, which is not empty, and state is also failure. Now here H is the goal. So here it is picked from the open, and that is removed from the open. Open will be having E, G, H, I and J. That H is checked for the goal using goal test function. Now H is goal, so it returns true. So if as this condition is true, it will execute the part now. Now state will be changed to success. That node H, which is the goal node, is added to the closed. And closed is now having A, C, F, B, D and H. In the next iteration, as this state has got changed, so this while condition fails, because success is not succession is false, and true and false is false. So this way it has executed the best first search so that the goal node is found. Now if you see the analysis of algorithm, you'll find that the search algorithm was executing in the depth first search fashion, but as the open list was getting sorted, the sequence of sort has got changed. So it was A to C, C to F, and from F it turns back to B, and from B to D and D to H. Now if you try to analyze this completeness, the best first search guarantees the solution, so that's why it is complete. Optimality, best first search is not the search which will give you low cost solution or best solution. So that's why it is not optimal, because you may have some alternate path which give the best solution. In our scenario, it was a simple execution of the algorithm on the graph having all the heuristic given. But assume that you have certain edge cost given in this graph and you want to find the shortest path. So in that case, it may happen so that the best first search may not give you optimal solution. Time complexity, if heuristic function is properly defined, then best first search gives you the solution with the linear time. And same is the case with the space complexity. If your heuristic function is accurately defined, then the search will take a linear space, otherwise it will take a significant space as it will be exploring new path each time. So hope that you have understood this best first search. So dear learners, how was the lecture? Hope that you have understood the best first search. Please subscribe to GCS Solution if you are not yet subscribed. Like the video if you really like it. Share among the friends if you find it useful. And please comment for the improvements. We are GCS Solutions, making technology easy to learn. Till next lecture, be intelligent.